There are would-be murderers all around the world who want to kill you and me and themselves because they're motivated by what they think is the highest ideal. Of course, politics are important. Iraq, Palestine, even social deprivation in Bradford. But as we wake up to this huge challenge to our civilized values, don't let's forget the elephant in the room, an elephant called religion. The suicide bomber is convinced that in killing for his God, he will be fast-tracked to a special martyr's heaven. This isn't just a problem of Islam. In this program, I want to examine that dangerous thing that's common to Judaism and Christianity as well. The process of non-thinking called faith. I'm a scientist, and I believe there is a profound contradiction between science and religious belief. There is no well-demonstrated reason to believe in God. And I think the idea of a divine creator belittles the elegant reality of the universe. The 21st century should be an age of reason, yet irrational, militant faith is back on the march. Religious extremism is implicated in the world's most bitter and unending conflicts.
We want the non-Muslims off the lands of Muhammad. We want the kuffar out of it.
America, too, has its own fundamentalists.
The issue for the next generation is going to be the Islamification of Europe.
And in Britain, even as we live in the shadow of holy terror, our government wants to restrict our freedom to criticize religion. Science, we are told, should not tread on the toes of theology. But why should scientists tiptoe respectfully away?
The time has come for people of reason to say enough is enough. Religious faith discourages independent thought, it's divisive, and it's dangerous.
It looks lovely, doesn't it? Inoffensive and gentle. But isn't this the beginning of that slippery slope that leads to young men with rucksack bombs on the tube? If you want to experience the medieval rituals of faith, the candlelight, incense, music, important sounding dead languages, nobody does it better than the Catholics. At Lourdes, in southern France, the assault on the senses appeals to us not to think, not to doubt, not to probe. And if we can retain our faith against the evidence, in the teeth of reality, the more virtuous we are.
Pretty impressive sight, isn't it? I could imagine finding it very seductive. Partly because of the tremendous feeling of group solidarity that there must be. If you have the delusion that you're Napoleon, it must be a fairly lonely feeling because nobody else agrees with you. Your faith that you're Napoleon needs a lot of shoring up. But these people here, thousands of people, all have exactly the same delusion. And that must give wonderful reinforcement to their faith.
I used to think reason had won the war against superstition, but it's quite shaking to witness the faithful droves trooping through Lourdes. This is a benign herd, but it supports a backward belief system that I believe reason must challenge. Daylight reveals more of this shrine, where a myth is perpetuated that a virgin who gave birth, Christ's mother Mary, appeared here once to an impressionable, and I do mean impressionable, young girl. The faithful make the pilgrimage here
because they believe that terrible afflictions can be cured by dragging their poor bodies up to a pool of water where the Virgin Mary made her miraculous appearance. In reality, they're probably more likely to catch something from the thousands of other pilgrims who've wallowed in the same water.
Is it something that Catholics feel they ought to do in their life, rather like Muslims going on the Hajj to Mecca?
Well, yes, but you don't have to be a Catholic to do it, you see.
No.
I mean, any religion can come, because I know
yes.
quite a few people that are not Catholics at all, and they have been...
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yes. And what are you hoping to get out of it?
Well, I've got a lot out of it. I've got faith, I've got trust,
yes.
and a belief that there is a person up there
right.
stronger than any medical person.
Right. What about a cure, then?
It may seem tough to question these poor, desperate people's faith. But isn't bracing truth better than false hope? What is the evidence for any miracles?
There are actually 66 declared miracles. There are about 2,000 unexplained cures here. But then we would say there are millions of people who have been healed in different ways.
Healed in some sort of mental way?
Healed in spiritual way are people who have come to terms with their own particular situation. People who have rediscovered God in their lives again. People who have received a new grace here in Lourdes.
So you tend to get about 80,000 per year who
come. About 80,000 sick pilgrims who come
yes.
here every year.
That's been going on for more than a century now, for
yes.
a century and a half.
Yes.
So 80,000 per year, and of those, 66 have been cured.
Right.
I'm just, you see what the way
yeah.
I'm thinking.
Yeah.
So the hard fact is that over the years, with their millions of pilgrims, there have been 66 supposed miracles. Statistically, it adds up to no evidence at all.
I can't help remarking that nobody has ever had a miraculous regrowing of a severed leg. The cures are always things that might have got better anyway.
People lean on their faith as a crutch, but I fear the comfort it provides is a shallow pretense. And I want to look at how the suspension of disbelief inherent in faith can lead to far more dangerous ideas beyond. People like to say that faith and science can live together side by side, but I don't think they can. They're deeply opposed. Science is a discipline of investigation and constructive doubt, questing with logic, evidence, and reason to draw conclusions. Faith, by stark contrast, demands a positive suspension of critical faculties. Science proceeds by setting up hypotheses, ideas, or models, and then attempts to disprove them. So a scientist is constantly asking questions, being skeptical. Religion is about turning untested belief into unshakable truth through the power of institutions and the passage of time. Let me give you an example of this with the story of the Assumption of Mary. Catholics believe that Jesus' mother Mary was so important she didn't physically die. Instead, her body shot off into heaven when her life came to a natural end. Of course, there's no evidence for this. Even the Bible says nothing about how Mary died. The belief that her body was lifted into heaven emerged about six centuries after Jesus' time, made up, like any tale, and spread by word of mouth. But it became established tradition.